Obaseki reform project don't get boost as Edo cultivate 50,000 hectare oil palm plantation. Edo State Governor Godwin Obaseki don't talk say his administration don't make remarkable progress for area of forest regeneration as the state don't cultivate over 50,000 hectare oil palm plantations. Obaseki talked this one when he received the British High Commissioner to Nigeria, Katrina Liang, where they on courtesy visit for Government House for Benin City. He points said the target now to cover over 200,000 hectares still seek the support of the British government take realize the vision. The governor notes say the British government don't help establish the best forestry governance system before for Benin City. Con state say as crude oil start, replace him.
At the turn of the century, you, the British, helped us establish perhaps the best forestry governance system in the Commonwealth, the British Commonwealth, here in Benin City. And unfortunately, as a result of various developments, particularly the advent of crude oil, that generation passed by, and the next generation were not, they were not attracted into forestry and the environment. And so we've had that hiatus, we've had that gap for about one or two generations, which we need to. We produced the best conservators of forests in this country from here. We had very well-developed regeneration programs for our forests. It's all documented. But if you come to our forestry agency today, it's aged, right? You know, we have a lot of aged professionals. We've not retrained to the extent we should have. And we've not given tools. We've not policed our forests the way we should police them. And they are now becoming havens for kidnappers and terrorists today. But we've done quite a bit of work. We've done a forest audit. We know the spaces that are very badly degraded and may not be, you know, cannot be used for forestry purposes anymore. Those areas we have mapped, we have surveyed, we've done some ground truthing, and created a program, a very well-structured oil palm program. We are ultimately going to make about 150,000 hectares of land available. The first 50,000 has been done under a very well-defined and structured program, which takes, you know, into account a very strong community action program. You know, the communities must be involved. There must be free and prior consent, you know, programs in place before, you know, investors go into the communities. We're also ensuring that a lot of emphasis is placed on outgrowers so that we can sustain livelihoods in the communities, and making sure that we use oil palm as a pointer or a trigger also for reforestation. We are going to be counting on your support because we've now enacted about 202,000 hectares of new forest land that can be regenerated for forestry purposes.
Governor Obaseki still renewed the call for the return of the Benin artifacts for United Kingdom, as the note say it will help inspire and re-energize the state's young population to recreate.
Your presence here is the continuation of a century-old relationship. Many people may not know that after the unfortunate incident of 1897, there was quite a lot of strong British presence in Benin City. And as part of what we're doing with creating a cultural district is we've identified some tombstones, graveyards, where members of the British garrisons were buried, you know, somewhere in one of the cultural district we're going to be creating. So we've had this century-old, you know, relationship that's gone through its various iterations, and so we're very glad that you're here, and we're hoping that this will help us reenact the very positive aspects of that relationship. And talking about the positive aspects you've mentioned, first, it's about culture. It's the cultural relationships we've enjoyed, and it's interestingly encapsulated in the whole debate about the return of the Benin bronzes. I think for us, I take as a government, it's the relationship, it's beyond bronzes. It's about creating, utilizing the meaning of those words. And meaning, those words mean, you know, much more to us. It represents our culture, who we are. It represents our creativity as a people. It also represents our innovation. For us as a government is, how do we get these works here to influence and re-energize our young people? I mean, this state, in terms of our demographics, over 65% are under the age of 32 years. And many of them do not have that connection with these works. When I went to Germany and actually felt and touched some of these pieces, I was just in awe, thinking, how could people 400 years ago, you know, could have manufactured or created pieces like this that are so pristine, so, you know, so fine? I mean, what sort of technologies, what sort of measuring instruments did they have? So for us there, I think it's important that the works are returned. It's important that the works are made available to a whole generation of younger Nigerians and Edo people to help them reconnect with who they are. It's important that we see culture, you know, and these works as a trigger to create and to utilize our culture to attract tourism.
For our part, Katrina Liang talks say the United Kingdom, they're ready to partner with the Edo State government to fight climate change and deforestation with the use of oil palm trees. The High Commissioner talks say she dey Edo to follow up on commitments where Niger make on top forest regeneration for the 2021 United Nations Climate Change Conference, COP26, we hold for Glasgow. She emphasized said the goal not to ensure said the oil palm approach they're sustainable for the good of not only Niger, but the world as a whole.
In the UK, it is our museums, British Museum, who have responsibility for those decisions in terms of returns of artifacts. So our discussion was around what the governor's vision is for how he's going to inspire, as he said, the youth of the country to learn from their heritage, from their history, and to adapt their artistic taste for the modern world, and I think he has a very good vision for that. So there are some that are being returned. The cockerel from Cambridge University, I understand, will shortly be returning to Nigeria. Is it here already? Or coming soon,
I think.
So there are some that are on the way. As I was mentioned, in the UK system, it is the individual museums who make the decision through their trustees. So I will certainly be going to visit the British Museum when I'm next back, COVID allowing, to look at the collection and to get an understanding of their plans. And I will be keeping in close touch with the governor on their plans so that we can work together in a constructive way.
From Benin, Osatuame Ogbeide.